our students have all the knowledge they need to build a search engine, but what are they missing?
Well, a few thousand of these. We're standing in front of a Google server rack. This is a web server, but it's using Ethernet to connect these different boards, which are actually separate computers that they put together in a rack. These are just generic PCs, because you can run a search engine at home on one computer, but it's not going to have a very big index.
How many are we talking about? Tens?
Many, many, many thousands. Google was not a particularly well-known one in its early years. Most of these search engines, I mean, today we think of them as being incredibly wealthy companies. At the time, they were mostly losing money. They had venture capitalists put money in, but they basically didn't make enough money from selling ads to pay their bills. Search engines actually go back before the web. On the internet, there were several search engines. The closest to what we have today might be Waze, done in the late 80s, and that lets you search different servers over the internet. Then we have, for instance, CERN Virtual Library, which was done by Tim Berners-Lee, the main inventor of the web. But that wasn't really like a modern search engine. It was more like a library card catalog where you had categories. Early Yahoo was like that as well. The one that got the most recognition was AltaVista. And this was kind of like the Google of its day in the late 90s. One that was a little bit different was Ask Jeeves, which was a search engine, but it was also meant to be natural language query. So you could say, like, what's the capital of Spain? And it would give you the answer. Google borrowed an idea from a little search engine called GoTo.com, which was to not just have ads, but to sell the search terms themselves. So like when you go to Google now and you see the sponsored results, those are actual terms related to what you're searching for, but they're also ads. And that just took off. I mean, people really responded to that, and that actually brought the entire search industry from on its way down to being one of the most profitable parts of web commerce.